actually, that's what I got.
Pretty good spot.
I gotta go by.
The middle school one.
Huh?
I don't know yet. Just a minute.
The great locomotive test. The great locomotive test.
Oh, something March.
Newcastle March. Newcastle March.
Oh, 8th grade.
What did he say?
They played that in the 8th grade.
September 11th attack on our nation, and I was at the Tampa airport, and people were afraid to fly. It was very, very nervous. There was military people running all over the place, and as I got off the plane and began to walk through this ramp, I began to hear this music. It was such beautiful orchestra music, and all these people began to walk to it, and these smiles appeared on their face, and the Hillsborough County All-Something Orchestra or band was playing, and it was just amazing. At a time of this great crisis, these young people were bringing all these smiles and comfort to these people watching it. It just naturally brought this sense of calmness to that airport. And I thought to myself, if we do anything, we can't touch our music program, our fine arts program, and how wonderful.
All right.
As a matter of fact, this past year we've even expanded it a little bit. But how wonderful it would be to skate at the Pensacola Airport when people got off and began to walk that ramp, they could hear this wonderful, powerful music that your children and our students perform. You're very fortunate to have such great and talented students. I'm very fortunate to be a superintendent that can brag about them. This is a great deal of fun. Enjoy the rest of the evening, folks. Thank you.
I want to take a minute and recognize a few other people, principals and other administrators and teachers in the school district. If you are here, would you stand and let us recognize you, please?
Thank you so much. I want to also echo what Mr. Wooten and Dr. Durr just mentioned about your parents. And I want to say a very special and personal thank you for all the sacrifices that you make. We appreciate it. I'd like to introduce our spring team. Pam Little, she teaches at Pine Forest High School, Wedgwood, Bellevue, and Brownsville Middle School. Doc Verdi, the Chorale Prelude by Bach, and Chukach by Strelach. Right now, I'd like to introduce our concert master, Miss Mary Ann Lane, and she will come out and get the orchestra tuned for us.
Good
Our all-county orchestra conductor tonight is Kirk Moss. He is an assistant professor in music education at Valdosta State University. He also holds a title of education director for the Valdosta Symphony Orchestra and leads the South Georgia String Project. He serves on the National Executive Board of the American String Teachers Association with National School Orchestra Association and is a past president of Georgia's American String Teachers Association. He has taught strings at the elementary, middle, and high school levels. His orchestra at Walton High School near Atlanta performed at the Midwest Clinic, Jubilee 2000 in Italy, and earned numerous festival awards, as did his orchestra at his previous school, the Davidson Fine Arts Magnet School in Augusta, Georgia. His string teaching career began in Louisville, Kentucky. He received his Master of Music degree from the Cincinnati College Conservatory of Music, his Bachelor of Music degree from the University of Michigan, and he is currently pursuing his PhD at the University of Florida. His articles on string teaching appear in numerous journals, and he serves on the editorial committee of the Music Educators Journal. Please help me welcome our 2003 All-County Orchestra Conductor, Mr. Kirk Moss.
Thank you. comes from, Bach premiered it in 1731. That's the greatest thing about the orchestral repertoire, is the, just the enormous longevity of history behind what we do. But the exciting thing was, in Bach's day, they didn't have the modern symphony orchestra. So a 20th century conductor, Eugene Normandy, took this piece and arranged it for the modern symphony orchestra, orchestrated it in 1940 for the Philadelphia Orchestra, which he was the famed conductor of. So we present to you Eugene Ormandy's transcription realization of Bach's Sleepers Awake.
Thank you.
has a wonderful career and is a terrific person. And so this is one of her pieces. It's not published, it's a manuscript. And we're very excited to present it as we play. Picture the colors you might encounter when you see the grandeur of this extraordinary mountain range for the first time.